Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan, and I'm going to play a Mercadia Masks draft. I did write a card review, or compile the card review rather, on MTGO Strat, but my main information source is this article. Excellent article by Florian Kosch. I'll link to it. And I have played the format before. I won 3 drafts. I love the fact that there are Swiss drafts, so I hope I won't do too badly. I also have Goldfish available for checking out the value of cards. So enough talk, let's just do it. One interesting detail is the 3 drafts I actually won in Mercadia Masks is I won with blue-black, all of them. So I do have a tendency to play blue-black. I'm chatting with Chris Weaver right now, and he is playing blue-green, which I normally try to avoid, but he makes a good argument for it. These are the 12 broken rares of the format. Right, here we go. Richard on port, please.
The rare is Squirrel Wrangler. Which is nothing, right?
$0.72.
No great popper cards.
So, what are we going to do? Succulent, Form Tonic Peddler, Snake Pit. Sabrehands, Treetop Bracers, Wild Might. Velvis Peters. That's the only crap you can get with that. I think I'm going to go with the Nightwing Glider. I'm not sure about that. I should really have made the big window bigger. Ivory Mask was a great card at the time. So what do we have here? Harpy, that's the thing you can get with that mercenary card. Bogus Smugglers, Vicious Hunger is great, of course. But there is a Rebel Searcher. So I think I'm going to use Land Grant. How much is Land Grant? 231. Oh, I think I had to take it. The prices are falling and poker cards are falling, so it is probably worth a lot less than two. No, I'm keeping up with the Rebels here, knowing that Rebels is the best deck. Pale Moon. That's nothing, right? Fantasia, Glittering Lion. Okay. Tyus Warrior is a rebel. With the reverse lifelink. That's a rebel. And there's an Ancestral Mask. The mask is super expensive right now, but it's dropping. But 551 means I have to take the mask. Yep. And get rid of it. The inhibitor doesn't look very good. Leggate, 1-3 flyer. Devout Witness isn't a rebel.
Aura Fracture Wine Trellis, Balloon Peddler. One damage to each creature and each player. I don't want to be white-green, that sounds like a catastrophe. So, maybe the Caterham Brute is the best card here. The White Witness is a white creature, it's further cutting white. Yeah. Lawbringer. Pulverize. Driving Stone Chrismage, Nakaya Shade. Wow, that shade is crazy bad. But it was on the list of good cards, so maybe it isn't. Well, here's my Rebel. Definitely need another Rebel Searcher. Or five. Flowering Field. Charm Peddler. Buoyancy Flay Flows. Chiron Glider, Calling Earth. Rushwood Herald is pretty good. Charm Peddler seems so bad. Flowering Field can't be super bad. I stay in white. I think I'm doing quite a good job of cutting white. But once again, I don't have the results in this format. And I want to learn, so please comment. If you want to comment on a pick or a gameplay, please give me the minute and second where I make the mistake in question. So I can quickly find it and don't spend my day searching 2,000 YouTube videos. Right. We have the basis for Rebel deck here, but nothing really exciting yet. We can only search for two, so we need one of the three searchers. Forgotten Harvest. Is that a money card? Once perhaps, but not now. Okay, oh, I didn't read the card, it was pretty bad. What the hell? I suppose I could take Invigorate here. And I'm getting into white-green, which will be horrible, of course. Rain of Tears, Fugitive, Spiteful Bully, Trickster Mage. I don't have a Rebel Chain, I don't even have anything looking like a Rebel Chain. The only thing I can search for is two mana Rebels, and I don't have any. So I really need more Rebels. And it doesn't feel like white is drying up yet. It's more white coming my way. Wow. Horrible cards. Oh. Snake Pit seems to be the best card here. And green undoubtedly. No, not undoubtedly, but green looks open. So I might end up being white green, which is not really good. Not good at all. Okay, well, at least we have a decent curve-like thing looking. No, it isn't decent either. Sack a creature, regenerate target creature. Nah. Caterham Summons is still going around. Why is Chrismage here? It's in the article, right? It's one of the best red commons. It wasn't. Wingstone Rouse, next step. Balloon Peddler, perhaps. Wingstorm. Wow. Glider. No creatures in green. Those are sideboard cards, if anything. Three color is death in this format. So, let's see what we get. Oracle's Attendant seems pretty good. Catering Kidnappers. Treasure Beast. There's an Accumulated Knowledge. But it's dropping fast, right? 275. Doubt I'll get 2 for it. No, I gotta have something aggressive, so I'm going for the Treasure Beast. Word of Blasting. Sacred Prey. When was Dragonfly? Wow, 4 mana for 1-1 death that way. Sacred Prey. Oh, Diving Griffin. It's probably what I want here. I will definitely need Evasion. And I think I am white. Green. And I might have to main deck that Snake Pit. When a card has two opposing colors like that, and I don't have any of the colors, this is blue and black, then it's very likely that my opponent actually has blue or black in his deck. He specifically needs to be white, green, red, green, or red, white to avoid it. And that's not likely. Okay, 11 playables so far. That's good. And almost no money. Crumbling Sanctuary. I have no idea what that is. Sunken Field and Snare, Spike the Eldrator, Catchling, Rishal and Cutpurse. Spore Frog! Defender and Vec. What the hell? Horn Troll. Well, I am going for the Horn Troll. In my 3-drop deck. Sliptide Serpent, Dual Torque, Scandalmonger, Wishmonger. Wishmonger should be able to break creature stalls, but this is Silverglade Elemental. And I think he's much better. Deadly Insect is really good when the opponent doesn't have creatures, but in draft they will. Black looks super open. though, maybe they're not that good. Prevent all damage or would be dealt by enchanted creature. Well, that's removal. Which I am lacking very much in this deck. Another griffin. Well, that works for me. Clog the ground with gigantic... Oh, people are paying 3 tickets for ancestral masks. So I might just keep it. The ribcage spider is supposed to be really good. Try looks pretty decent as well. But the ribcage spider is a card that was featured in the article, so let's try it. Now that I look, when I look at the comments on the video, you will say that at 7 minutes you passed the Rishadon port, and then I will kill myself. Wow, is that even a sideboard card? I'm going for the insect here. Or do I want to disenchant for my sideboard? No, I'm taking the insect. Thinking creatures could be a way forward. Destroy all enchantments. Well, that's the sideboard card. Can you take some notes? I'm draft video number 1. We are 19th of December. So my first pick was Lawbringer, I think. No, Nightwing Glider. And now I have like a really crappy white-green creature deck. Checking my internet connection, yeah. Lash Knife, enchanted creatures first strike. Wow, is that playable? Why am I getting all these blue cards now? Sideboard, Reverent Silence. Jewel Torque. Woodwink. Witness. Well, I do have the witnesses to protect myself against artifacts or enchantments. 14 creatures. Silence. I'm not 100% convinced that I'm main decking Snake Pit, but I think it does more than Lash Knife does. But I don't have a problem getting to 22 playables. Avatar Will. Wow, 5-6 flyer. Monkey Cage is first pick quality. Howling Wolf. Defiant Falcon, there's my Rebel Searcher. And that will improve my deck. How many Rebels do I have? It isn't too many. Well, I do want a Monkey Cage. It's Hunger of the Howl Pack. No. Owl of the Night pack quality, or the Defiant Falcon. Jesus. Wow, this is hard. I did win with the Monkey Cage last time. So... No, I'm taking the Rebel. Ha! Damn it! I'm gonna lose to Monkey Cage now. Flint Golem. Seal of Cleansing. Rushwood Dryad seems solid. Not too many 2-drops in the deck. Deepwood Elder. X target lands become forests. Okay. But this is a 2-2 for 2. We also have the Pygmy Race. Oh, Blastoderm! Lawbringer, Lightbringer. I think it's Blastoderm here. And there is Spider Silk Armor, which I am going to pick. 23 cards! I'm only going to play 22! I want to play 18 lands in this format, but maybe I'm wrong. Maybe... Ooh! Silken Fist Order. Core Soldier. Another sergeant to get the Falcon. And then the Falcon can get these three guys. Well, at least that's something. But getting one more Rebel would be nice. Now I can put Snake Pit in the sideboard. And possibly the Linsect in the sideboard as well. No need to do that yet. Renounce. Animate land. Jolrael's favorite. Rushford. Herbalist. Well, the Herbalist seems pretty good. Another 3 drop. Now, of course, I'm not playing Ancestral Mask. Am I playing these other guys? A Witness could be in the sideboard. If necessary. But 18 creatures and 18 lands would feel sweet. But maybe I have no reason to play 18 lands if I have this many 3-drops. But I do want to hit my third mana. What about Flowering Field? It's definitely questionable. Velvet Portal. Dark Triumph. Fenstalker. Bog Smuggler. Glitterlings. Tiger Claws. Deepwood Dryad. Deepwood Drummer. I think the Drummer is decent. For smacking through. Drummer over Witness. Probably. Mercadian what? Lift. Okay. Damage. Talon, Sissel, Blaster Mage. Looks like white dried up. But I have 22 cards with one of those Devout Witnesses. Howling Wolf, not very good. Moss Dog. Why would that happen? And British Rebel. Not too sure about Invigorate either, but it should give me a card of value for 3 life. Timid Drake is pretty good. So I'm gonna hate that. How many Spell Shapers? Depot Drummer, the Regeneration Guy, and one Devout Witness. Is that reason enough for 18 lands? I would love to play 18 lands. I think I'm fine with this. 18 creatures, 18 lands. Flowering Field, Muscle. Well, there's the Razorback. Makes me question if I should have any Devout Witnesses. This guy is too, he's not, doesn't have the backup, right? Maybe I should have taken that for the sideboard. Can't speak and play at the same time. Tranquility for the sideboard. Vader, Flames. And we have a deck. A 17 land deck. Possibly. Okay, Treasure Beast, Silvergrid, Deadly Element, Deadly Insect, maybe not. Snake Pit, Reverent Silence, Wingstorm are in the sideboard. Spider Silk Armor, Rushwood Herbalist, Ribcage Spider, Invigorate, Horn Troll, Rushwood Dyad, Depot Drummer, Razorback. Griffin, Griffin, Nightwing Glider, Lightbringer, Devout Witness or not. Defiant Falcon, Flowering Field, Sergeant, Sergeant. Once the Falcon is dead, the Sergeant doesn't do anything. So are they worth playing? Not sure. I cut Lash Knife here. But something needs to go into the deck. And it is, oh, Muscle, of course. Okay, what about this then? Do I want to run 18 lands? Do I really need 18 lands? Well, it would be awesome to actually have this creature attack start as scheduled. Then I can throw away the lands. And have the witnesses in the sideboard. Yes, that is my decision. 9-9 seems good. I am saving it as MM. White green. And the plan is then to win with my 3 evasion creatures or smash through with the big guys. Do we believe in this? I hope we do. Sideboard out target is Flowering Field, Sergeant. Field and Sergeant. I don't know about the Sergeants. Invigorate. Well, let me know how you would have built the deck and what you would have done differently. All this great value in Mercadian Mask, but all I got was this Ancestral Mask, now worth $3.